April 7th, 1961. 4 degrees, 7 minutes, 61 seconds. September 25th, 2009. 9 degrees, 25 minutes, 9 seconds. For any triangle, when two angles and one side are known, the third angle and two sides can be calculated. I began plotting this complex geometry, building an equation of non-numerical factors, unbound by the gravity of quantum physics, a string of moments, invisible to the electron microscope, measurable only by the graces that I keep. Benediction lies between memory and fate, between light and stillness, in wine and dust.
Thank you.
Hi, yes, I'm not sure that I'm in the right place. I'm scheduled for an MRI, but I think I'm in the laundry room. Yes? Yes, yeah, that's right, yeah. Okay. Yes, I see it. Okay, really? Okay, thanks.
Welcome to the automated self-serve magnetic resonance imaging system. En español, press número uno. For recurring dizziness, headaches, and migraines, please press two. For head trauma or open wounds, please press three.
There's no numbers.
For all other neurological issues, please press four. You have chosen option four. One moment, please. The total amount due is $5,286. Please select payment option key.
Which is the,
You have chosen billing your insurance. Please insert your $10 copay. One moment, please. Please remove all metal objects and turn off all electrical devices. Take off pants and shirt and remain in your underwear. In as few words as possible, please describe the symptoms that you're experiencing.
Oh, well, my left arm doesn't swing whenever I walk, and my left leg drags a little bit. You know, kind of like John Wayne in one of them there Western movies, partner. Anyway, so I think I have a pinched nerve.
One moment, please. You have described your symptoms that appear to be affecting your left side. Is this correct?
Yeah, yes.
I'm sorry I didn't hear your response. Please speak your response clearly.
Yes.
One moment, please. Please open the porthole and place head inside.
Are you serious?
Please open the porthole and place head inside. Thank you. One moment, please. Please remain still. It is important that we are able to get a clear image for your diagnosis.
Sorry, I guess I'm just
please
a little nervous in here.
Please don't speak. Remain still. I want you to be a brave little cowboy.
Draw the live long day. just like Pollock. I walk like the Duke. My saddle is blazing to make some art, but I just can't find funding to buy my gun. My daddy said, son, you need a steady hand to shoot a gun. My saddle is blazing to make some art, but I just can't find funding to buy my gun. I got a belly full of silver bullets that make my days good, bad, and ugly, but I never wanted to be no cowboy.
When he called to tell me the news, all I could do was cry. I don't think I said a single word. I remember long stretches of silence over the phone, and then he would say something like, "We'll get through this." God, it drove me crazy every time he would say that, honestly. You know, every time he felt
the need to reassure me that this was going to be all right. I just wanted to scream, shut up! Nothing is all right. I don't want to get through this. I don't want to give up my life. I just got moved into management at work. I have 4 teams to manage in different cities. I need to travel. How am I going to leave him now? I've balanced a career and a family for the past 20 years. I sacrificed vacations. I did without. I'm in the prime of my life, and I want to be happy. I want to do things. You know, sometimes I think I should feel guilty for feeling this way, but what about me? You know, when he got this disease, we got it. And I don't want it any more than he does.
I am on the turnpike to Babylon, on the west side of the Jersey Wall. These great barriers shall not keep me from the experience of it all. Fields are lined with rifle towers, threaded through and standing tall. The Colossus of Rhodes once stood by here, now it's moved to the mall. There's so much that I can share with you, so please don't put any pennies on my eyes. In 7 seconds, I'll blink again, and we'll travel to Nepal. We are on the turnpike to Babylon, on the west side of the Jersey Wall. These great barriers shall not keep us from the experience of it all. Fields are lined with rifle towers, threaded through a standing tall. The Colossus of Rhodes once stood by here, now it's moved to the mall. There's so much that we can share with you, so please don't put any pennies on our eyes. In 7 seconds, we'll blink again, and we'll travel to Nepal. And we'll travel to...
We'll travel...
To...
To...
Tro... To...
We're gonna...
We'll...
Travel...
Travel...
they're all freezing. With no snow on the ground. Doctor said, son, you'll live a long, long time, but it's gonna be a monster of a climb. Ashes to angels without a sound. Angels to ashes will all fall down.
In my state, it's not clear whether the sun is coming up or going down. What is clear is that it's lingering on the horizon. In my state, it's not clear if I am moving or the world is moving past me. What is clear is that everything is in flux. In my state, it's not clear whether it's actually gotten quiet or that I just can't hear anything. What is clear is silence. In my state, it's not clear if I am breathing or if the air is rushing into and out of me all on its own. What is clear is that it has no taste. In my state, it's not clear how long I've been here. What is clear is that I need sleep.
Blown by the winds of Damocles, thrown against the shores of fate. What is our course, my captain, and how long must we wait? Can you lead us to the Holy Grail, or fill our pockets with gold? Help us navigate through this terrible disease before we grow too old. When the shaman rises from the dead, will he feed my family? Will he hold my wife through lonely Godspeed. The world is a monkey. Godspeed. Hear that owl of pride. Godspeed. Life is a monkey. Godspeed. Oh, my hand tonight. Godspeed.
Thank you. 20 after 7. I'm late for the 7 o'clock pill. Morning, John. Here's your Cinemet. Here's your yellow pill. And don't forget your vitamin E. It's a nice day outside, so you can go for a walk. 7 o'clock. Morning, John. Here's your Cinemet. Here's your yellow pill. And don't forget your vitamin E. It's snowing, and it isn't a good day to go for a walk. We'll see you. Hello? I missed the 7 o'clock. It's 10. Just wait for me. Sorry I'm late, John. Here's your Cinemet. Here's your yellow pill. And don't forget your vitamin E. I'm sorry I'm late, but this way you won't have to wait so long for lunch. 7 o'clock. Morning, John. Here's your Cinemet. Here's your yellow pill. And here's your vitamin E. It's a really nice day out. You're going to have a good walk. 7 again. Merry Christmas, John. Here's your Cinemet. Here's your yellow pill. And don't forget your vitamin E. We're going to have dinner at 2 o'clock, okay? We'll see you.
The door closes behind me, and I smile. I think about what he always says. When a door opens, walk through it. He's never missed an opening. But you know, I sometimes wonder if one of those doors led to Parkinson's. It's a 30-minute drive to his place, and I go through a lot of emotions along the way. It always shakes me up because he always looks a little worse. I hate this disease. And when he says, "Well, how do I look?" I tell him, "Great." He laughs. He's always laughing. So I asked him once, "How can you be happy all the time?" And he said, "You know, I've got two choices every day in my life. One is to be miserable, and two is to be happy. Which one would you pick?" So today, when I open his door and he says, "Hey, how do I look?" I'm gonna tell him, "I love you, but you look like crap." I pull in the driveway, grab my bag, head to the front door. The door opens. He says, "Well, how do I look?" And I don't know what to say. He's got a sweater stuck on his head. He's got his two arms are straight up in the air, and he's looking at me through what might be a sleeve. I get him unstuck and say, "It is a good thing that I came today." And he says, "Hell, it's a good thing I put on my pants first." It never takes long to feel comfortable around him. We talk about a lot of things. I don't want to leave. I never want to leave. And then he says something to me today that I will never, ever forget. As he slowly gets out of a chair, with his hands trembling, he says,
"How you spend your days is the way you spend your life."
I'll take the wings of a crow, tie them to your pen. I'll run through them cornfields and watch it all fly away. I'll grab a spade from the barn. We'll meet on the hill. Leave your watch at home, and we'll bury all of the pills. pounding. It'll be a brand new day. Then we'll go down into the basement, pull out the old bags. I'll wrench you out of that wheelchair, and we'll pedal off into the night. Then we will dance to the radio, wrestle out on the lawn. We'll walk the rails by the river and listen to the trains all day long. Nothing will matter if things are not the same. I'll take the wings of a crow.